We left the ranch on our first day of the trip and headed for Montana. We only made it as far as outside Ritzville when we had a blowout and had to go back in and call road service at Ritzville. Finally, getting back on our way, we made it to Spokane where we bought a spare tire, and later in the afternoon, a long day, we made it to St. Regis, our first stop. We always liked going to those St. Clark Caverns, and that was our second stop, a short drive that day. We made it in time to take a tour in the afternoon and then spend the rest of the night in the Since we had some extra time, we took a detour down to Virginia City and enjoyed the day down in Virginia City, wandering around, taking a tour that was very informative. And then we headed up to Bozeman. It's got a nice little lake with a night in a nice park just outside of Bozeman with a pool for the boys. After leaving Bozeman, we went to Laurel, Montana, which is near Billings, and visited Yoshiko's friend Bonnie. We had a nice lunch with Indian tacos that she made fresh right there for us. And then her daughter, Carrie, was there with her boys, and we played with them all day, and then went out to their house and spent the night plugged into their house. And they have a big, beautiful house outside Billings on the hilltop, and the boys thought this was the best time to go into the village. After leaving Carrie's house in Billings, we went first to Pompey's Pillar, which was only about 20 minutes away, and then we headed down to Little Bighorn Battlefield and toured that before spending the night in Gary Owen at a nice RV ranch down there. Thank you. to Devil's Tower, and it was beautiful when we first saw that, and it was also on the 4th of July. What was great is we stayed at the KOA, and they had a beautiful, wonderful 4th of July display that night, and we've missed 4th of July for the last couple of years. We've been on track, and so it was great to see 4th of July. We drove the Needles Highway and a couple other highways with this little car. Luckily, we had that to rent because we couldn't fit the RV through these roads and the skiddy tunnels. We took the Wildlife Loop Road, but we didn't see a whole lot of wildlife. We saw a few things there, some antelope, donkeys, but we didn't find the buffalo until we left the park, and then we saw thousands of buffalo along the road and on the hillsides. when Keystone was taking this tram and slide. You had to ride the chairlift up the hill, and then you get to take the slide down. And that was a fun one.
Myself, what a wonderful